Welcome back my dear student on my YouTube channel. I am GT sir from LPM Public School. Today we are going to discuss about the topic One Child, One Teacher, One Book, One Pen. And it is the this chapter has been extracted from the autobiography I Am Malala. Okay. In the previous we have known about the first and second part. We have discussed about the first and second part, and today I am going to explain the third part of the chapter. Okay, so listen carefully, and if you have to any problem then comment in the comment box. So let's start the chapter. In the way Yusuf Malala tells about her mother's feeling and her father's feeling, then he tell next about her life. Okay, he says it's as if you planted a tree and nurtured it. You have the right to sit in its shade. It means when you planted any kind of the tree and you also care of the plants. Nurtured means care. Okay, nurtured means care. And if you care of the plants with your happiness, then you have to write. Okay, then you have to write to sit under its shade. It means as you show, as you get. Okay, as you show, as you get. So this is the mean of the statement of the Malala's. Okay. Next, she says that his dream in life was to have a very big school in short, providing quality education, and to live the peacefully, and to have democracy in our country. It means next dream of the Malala, that was the he built a school that was the powerful, providing quality of education. Okay, the school providing powerful quality of education, and it lives peacefully, and to have a democracy in our country. Okay, there are no any bureaucracy, no it will be the democracy. And it's what he had achieved, the respect and status in society through his activities and the help he gave people. And next he tell that with the power he had also achieved the respect and status in the society by her best activity and by the help of the people, and they also help her now it is. Okay, he never imagined living abroad, and he gets upset when people suggest we wanted to come to the UK. Okay, it means he never think about that she settles with her family in the abroad means foreign. Okay, and he gets upset when people suggest we wanted to came to the UK. It means many of the people suggested her to came back her country. Okay, and when she heard such type of the statement by the people, she became very upset. And a person who has 18 years of education, a nice life, a family, you throw him out just as you throw a fish out of the water for speaking of the girl's education. And then he also gave example that happened with her father. He said that a person, it means her father, also do hard work in a Pakistan, and where he also fight for the girl's education and doing more things to living of her nice life, nice family, for the education of the girls and the public of that country through him, just like a fish out of the water. Okay, and often over meals we talk about home and try to remember things, we miss everything, even the smelly stream. Already some of the things from the swath seems like stories from a distant place, like somewhere I have read about. Okay, and next he tell that she talking about the meals, it means food that he takes in a Pakistan, and he also miss the home and try to remember things. He always try to remember all the things that she miss in the Pakistan, and she also miss the smelly stream that he take in a previous country. And already some of the things from Swat seems like a stories from the distant place. Okay, it now she think that all these accidents that happened in their old country, she looks like a stories, and it is what kind of the story? Stories from a distant place, and like somewhere I have read about. Okay, and my father spent much of his time going to conferences on education. I know it's odd for him that now people want to hear him because of me, not the other way around. I used to be known as his daughter, now he known as my father. When he went to France to collect an award for me, he told the audience, in my part of the world, most people are known by their sons. I am one of the few lucky fathers known by his daughters. And after that, he says that his fathers spend more time to going or attending the conferences or assembly on education. It means he attend a lot of the time to many of the conferences and assembly for the education. Okay, and Malala says that he know very well that it is the odd for him, and it is very strange for him that the people want to hear him. Okay, why? Because of Malala, because of her. Okay, and not the other way round. I used to be known as his daughter, and many of the daughters known by her father's name, but here is the opposite of that situation. It means her father's known by his daughters. Okay, and now he is known as my father's when he went to the France to collect an award. And now, but here is the Malala says that I know very well that he is my father. And he also explained about a accident when he went to the France to collect the award for Malala's, and there he told to the audience that in the part of the world, most people, it means many of the part of the country, it means world, there are many people known by their sons, but here is, it means her father's known by her father is very lucky person that known by his daughters. Okay, I don't want to be thought of as the girls who was shot by the Taliban, but the girls who fought for education. This is the cause to which I want to devote my life. Okay, here is the cause, means an aim or a brief which a group of people supports, fight or fights for. Okay, it means I don't want to be thought of as the girls who was shot by the Taliban. Okay, it means when she fought for the girls education and the shot by the Talibani, then here the Malala said that I am do not know that moment of the accident. Okay, and this is the cause to which I want to devote my life, and it is the only reason that she devote her life for the girls education. Okay, now next, on my 16th birthday, I was in New York to speak at the United Nations. Standing up to addresses an audience inside the vast hall where so many world leaders have spoken before was daunting, but I knew what I was wanted to say. Okay. Here he tell the next accident, and the accident will happen on his 16th birthday. Okay, and she was in New York to speak at the United Nations. Okay, it is the first time when she reached at the United Nations to addressing of the peoples. When she standing for the addressing of the audience inside the vast hall, it means big hall, where she has a lot of the leaders who spoken about many points, many frightening and difficulties, many points. But when he standing before them, he facing frightening and difficulties before them. But he know very well what she wanted to say. Okay, this is your chance, Malala. I said to myself, and he tell to herself that it is the first chance for her. Okay, only 400 people were sitting around me, but when I looked out, I imagined million more. I did not write my speech with the UN delegate in mind. I wrote it for every person around the world who could make a difference. I wanted to reach people living in poverty, whose children forced to work, and those who suffered from terrorism or lack of education. Deep in my heart, I hoped to reach every child who could take courage from my word and stand up for his of rights. Next, she says that when she stand in the vast hall, and he became very nervous. Okay, but here he know that what is the matter of the speak, and he looks, there are 400 people in the vast hall, but he imagine that it is not 400 people, that it is a millions more people. Okay, and when she speaks, she writes a speech note in a UN delegates means person chosen to the speak word of the make decisions for a group of the people. Okay, it means she going for the million of people in UN, and she wrote a matter to speak about the education, and she think that it is not only 400 people, it is the million of the people that she wanted to reach, the people living in poverty. She know that those children who forced to the work and those who suffered from the terrorism, there are many problems created before him, and they face many difficulties, just like that poverty and labors and not getting the education and suffered from the terrorism. It is the many problem, and here the Malala hoped to reach every child who could take courage from her words and stand up for his own her rights. It means he wanted to encourage all that type of the person, and for the education, the person who listen her. Okay, I called on the world's leaders to the provide free education to every child in the world. Let us pick up our books and our pens. I said they are our most powerful weapons. On one child, one teacher, one book and one pen can change the world. Wow, it is the good speech by the Yusuf Malala. He says that he called the world's leader. It means there are many leaders came into the UN assembly, and there she says to the every leader to provide free education to every child in the world. And he says to the leader that let us pick up the books and our pens. It means we need to pick the books and pens. And he next he says that they are our most powerful weapons. It means the books and pens are most powerful weapons for us, and it is used for the one child, one teacher, one book and one pen can change the world. Okay, only the one teacher, one child, one pen, one book can change the world. And I didn't know how my speech was received until the audience gave me a standing ovation. Okay, it means in respect of the speech, in respect of the statement given by the Malala, all the person will stand and give the ovations. Okay, and this is the good speech given by the Yusuf Malala in the UN Assembly. So here is the Malala is the we can say that she is an iron lady, that iron lady of the Pakistan who fought for the education of the girls and the poor people are the poor people and liberal persons. And it is very necessary to everyone to fight or struggle for the education of every person in your country, in your district, in your village. Okay, if you make a educated a person, then you make 100 of the person educated. Okay, so I hope you all understand about this chapter. We meet in the next video by taking the book exercise of the chapter. So thank you for the watching video.